areas where reports coming in indicate a scarcity of maize grain and flour has hit the area, with residents crying foul. It's understood that a wholesale kilogram of grain has jumped from 400 shillings to 700, while flour rose from 1,300 to 1,400. Some of the traders who spoke to New Vision on Air say this could have been triggered by the Kenya government lifting its ban on the importation of Ugandan maize.
The maize grain traders have been left redundant with their weighing scales hanging. Charles Onen Chan, a large-scale maize grain dealer in Sierra Leone market, says the high demand has led to the rise in the price.
Experiencing scarcity in maize. Generally, it was very low and people were crying, maize were rotting in the stores. In the village, it was only 400, and then we are trying here and there to sell it in town here at only 500 to millers. I think the price will keep on going, and then it will reach a point where a new maize will come into the market, and then the price will go down a bit.
Stephen Odong says local farmers have refused to sell maize because they expect the price to rise further. The effect is also felt by retailers. Innocent, who sells along Ring Road, quotes her price at 900 shillings. On the 5th of March 2021, Kenya implemented a ban on the importation of Ugandan maize, citing high quality of aflatoxins.
Because when you go to the village to pick that maize, even farmers are complaining that the price is low, the price is low. Because for the past, I think, 3 years ago, the price of maize has risen up to, the price of maize has shot up to 1,500 per kilogram. So the price is not all that okay. And besides, even people are searching for maize, there's no maize.
Ojuka Thomas believes that government should intensify sensitization of farmers on quality produce in order to avoid future bans from other countries.
We fluctuated the price. Other people still have maize in stock, as you see. We still have maize in stock. But at least farmers learned something. All we ask for the Minister of Agriculture to help us with this. Last year we saw, I don't know if it was the Minister of Agriculture, they distributed taplings to help farmers in post-surface handling. But it was only done in one side. We have maize here at 700, 750, and you hear the same thing in Kampala. You see, usually there was that gap of 200, 250 shillings. It was easy for us to buy and sell to Kampala. But now you see, you have to wait for traders to come here direct. So it has affected us.
Story by Joseph Omagro for the news in Gulu City.